राष्ट्रीय महिला मोर्चा अध्यक्षा श्रीमती वनाती श्रीनिवासन जी, भौणी आमर कोयंबटूर साउथ रु विधायक अच्छा एवं आपण माने जानी जे से अंचल बहुत ख्यातनामा कलाकार कमला हसन को मध्य निर्वाचन में हर आम सहित आम सहित अच्छा शिर्षार सांसद हरियाणा श्रीमती सुनीता दुग्गल जी सी मध्य टीम रे सामिल अच्छा टीम अन्यतम मेंबर श्रीमती श्रीरूपा मित्र भौणी होती मालदारु विधायक टीम रे आम सहित अच्छा श्रीमती आरती सिंह जी हो महिला मोर्चा झारखंड संपादक एवं ओडिशा महिला मोर्चार प्रभारी एवं टीम रे अन्यतम सदस्य होती भौणी प्रियल भारद्वाज जी दिल्ली महिला मोर्चार उपसभानेत्री एवं ए टीम रे सामिल अच्छा सहित आज आम मंच उपस्थित अच्छा राज्यर महिला मोर्चा सभानेत्री श्रीमती स्मृति पट्टनायक महोदया आम सहित अच्छा भुवनेश्वर सांसद श्रीमती अपराजिता षडंगी महोदया आम सहित अच्छा ओडिशा बीजेपी उपसभानेत्री श्रीमती प्रभाती परिडा महोदया एवं टीम जहां जहां अनुध्यान करके आसला जहां आलोचना करके आसला सबू कथा आपण रखिए ओडिशावासी को विव्रत कर विषय खुलासा हो सत्य सामना को आसु दोषी दंडित हूँ ये आम समस्त इच्छा एवं 4.5 कोटी ओडिया इच्छा समस्त को धन्यवाद जन भौणी मनाती श्रीनिवासन को अनुरोध करुच्ची आपण आगे सबू विषय रखिए धन्यवाद
नमस्कार गुड मॉर्निंग टू मीडिया फ्रेंड्स एज पर द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द ऑनरेबल नेशनल प्रेसिडेंट श्री जेपी नड्डा जी वी एज अ 3-member टीम हैव कम टू ओडिशा द डायरेक्शन गिवन टू अस इज टू विजिट द फैमिली ऑफ द विक्टिम and to interact with the people of that area and to submit a report to him. Since yesterday morning we are interacting with the local people, public representatives, police officials, and we have visited the family of the victim. It is such a brutal murder. A girl who is hailing from an ordinary weaver's family, after her education, for her earnings, she has joined in a school. The school is being taken care by the accused of the present criminal case, Govind Sahu. Not on the political angle, just we would like to tell you about the doubts or the suspicion of any common man they have. The constancy being represented by the present MOS home, Mr. Dibyashankar Mishra. The accused of the present criminal case, Govind Sahu, is not a close aide of the home minister. And he is not only the close aide, and he is being seen as the representative of the home minister in the region. Often they had traveled together. Often the home minister, he had visited that school. Even the financial assistance from the MLA fund is being given to the school. They have got some information. And the accused of the present criminal case, who has visited Chief Minister's residence along with the Home Minister several times, it is all in the public domain. Initially, when the girl's parents, they have approached the police station to lodge an FIR, they have been dragged by the police department. And after investigation, Govind Sahu was interrogated for 3 days. But surprisingly, an unscheduled power cut has happened in the police station, he escaped. Then after that, the police has secured him. And now the DIG has given a press statement saying that it is some kind of a personal thing. And Govind Sahu has confessed that the victim has threatened him of exposing some kind of a relationship. Yesterday we also met the superintendent of police, Balangir. Our team and other local public representatives, we have met him. We have raised our doubts. Yes, of course, for some questions he has answered. He was telling that some of the body parts were handed over to the family of the victim and some objects have also been given back. We were asking about the forensic report. That is still pending. Media friends, I would like to tell you, investigation officer is under the Home Department. The constituency where the crime has occurred, it comes under the Home Minister. The accused is not an ordinary citizen of that particular assembly constituency. He is being seen as the representative of the Home Minister. Everything comes under the Home Ministry. Now, taking the confession statement and conducting the trial is another step in getting the justice. But conducting the trial also involves the Home Ministry. The police department has to conduct a free and fair investigation, and another important thing, that trial has to take place. That everything is to happen under the Home Ministry. It is not only the political parties, community organization, general people, they are telling that there is some big hand in this present criminal case. And in that situation, BJP Odisha unit is making a demand of removal of the Home Minister from the ministry. Repeatedly, they were demanding the state president, member of parliament and our state office bearers, and series of agitations were being taken place in Odisha in the past 10 days. Even today on behalf of Mahila Morcha, in every district, under the guidance of our state Mahila Morcha president Srimati Smriti Patnaik, they are conducting agitations. This is being the situation, we feel that on the basis of the moral responsibility and also on the basis of the suspicion and the doubts, the Home Minister must step down. After a long time, yesterday evening he has given a press statement in the name of Goddess Manikeshwari. In the name of Lord Manikeshwari, in the name of Lord Jagannath, we are also demanding, we are also requesting the Home Minister to step down from the ministry for the sake of free and fair investigation and trial. As far as the other aspect of this incident, our team members, they would address about the issue.
No, no, she will say after that I will conclude. Yes,
she will conclude.
Anything else? No, no, no. In a very timeline manner.
Shabaki Namaskar. I am just following what our national president of Mahila Morcha, Mananiya Bharati Srinivasan ji, has stated. As you know, we have come here under the direction of our national president, Mananiya Sri J.P. Nadda ji. We, the team members and the women leaders and entire BJP family, we are extremely pained at the tragic incident that has occurred among the weavers community of Odisha. You all are aware that the victim in this case, she belonged to the Meher community, which is a well-known weaving community, and we respect them for the work they do in the society. The victim, she was not only a Meher community girl, she is well educated, and she was serving as a teacher and a hostel warden in a school in Kalahandi area. We are deeply pained to meet their family, especially the mother was inconsolable. We found that the entire family, they are frightened. They are in the grip of fear and they do not feel like meeting people or meeting the media because they are all the time crying and crying for the peace of the victims as well as they are seeking justice. The mother who was crying in front of us, she was breaking down, she was getting fainted, and we got the report that her health condition is not good. She had the different occasions. She was getting fainted, and we were surprised that from the government side, there was no help, no assistance given to the family. I would like to point out on behalf of our team that we in the central government have enacted a victims compensation fund and 24 states including Odisha has notified that scheme and yet no financial compensation or no facility for medical treatment of the traumatized mother has reached there. On behalf of my team, we like to recommend and appeal through you to the government of Odisha that the victim compensation fund must be used immediately
to help the family, to help the mother, to help them to come out of the trauma and psychological condition that we have noticed. I would also like to point out that there is a witness protection scheme which is enacted by the National Legal Services Authority under the Ministry of Law and Justice. And as you know, the authority is patronized and chaired by the Chief Justice of India, and at the state level, it is chaired by the Honorable Chief Justice of the state. The state has been entrusted to implement witness protection scheme which is available to the authority. We have noticed that in various corners of the society, right from the school and the college where the incident has occurred and the villages where the families are living and the entire Meher Weavers community, we have seen they are demanding justice and they are raising finger to the big wigs, the people who are holding high political positions, including the MOS home in this case. Therefore, we believe, we are of the opinion that the entire gamut of witnesses that the SP of the district yesterday mentioned, that they have found a number of witnesses in this case and they have recorded the evidence of the witnesses, we fear, and on behalf of the voiceless and families of the victim, we would like to raise this point that witness protection scheme should be used by the state government to protect the witnesses in this particular case. To summarize, I would say that Bharatiya Janata Party, Bharatiya Janata Mahila Morcha, we work like a family, and we would like to make a statement that we are all supporting and standing by the family of the victim,
yes,
at this hour of grief and tragedy, and we request the state government to immediately compensate financially and otherwise, provide the medical treatment to the traumatized family members and look after the protection angle of the witnesses so that the case is strengthened. We know we have lost the girl. She is no more there to fight her case. So the state has to defend the victim and her rights. That is the constitutional duty that the state has been entrusted with. So we as a committee, we are going to submit our report to Honorable National President Maniya Shri J.P. Nadda ji, and we are also going to record our feelings and the feelings of people of Odisha, the feelings of people of Meher community and the feelings of people of Kalahandi, Bolangir and our state unit, and we hope that the justice should be meted out to this unfortunate case. Thank you very much.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सभी छायाकार बंधुओं का. अभी जिस तरह से कि हमारी राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्षा वानती जी ने और श्री रूपा जी ने आप लोगों के समक्ष एक एक करके सभी बातों को रखा, मैं ये ऐड करना चाहती हूँ उसमें कि एनसीआरबी की रिपोर्ट के मुताबिक उड़ीसा आज की तारीख में क्राइम अगेंस्ट वुमेन में सेकेंड नंबर पर है पूरे भारतवर्ष के अंदर, और पिछले दो तीन सालों के अंदर 26% जो है वो क्राइम अगेंस्ट वुमेन वो इंक्रीज किया है, और उसमें भी हालत ये है कि जो कन्विक्शन रेट है वो मात्र 9.2% है। इन सब बातों को देखकर हमारे केंद्रीय नेतृत्व ने ये निर्णय लिया कि उड़ीसा राज्य में यहां की सरकार महिलाओं की सुरक्षा को लेकर संजीदा नहीं है, इसलिए इसको राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर मामले को रखना चाहिए। और इसीलिए उन्होंने हम 3 मेंबर्स की जो कमेटी है वो गठित की। हम सब लोगों ने जैसा कि वानती जी ने बताया ग्राउंड रियलिटीज को जानने की कोशिश की, परिवार से मिले, और उन सब बातों को देखकर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन से भी हमारी मुलाकात हुई। हमें ये नजर आ रहा है कुछ हमारी ऑब्जर्वेशंस उसमें जो हैं, नंबर 1 कि जो एक्यूज है उसका होम मिनिस्टर साहब जो हैं उनके साथ एक क्लोज एसोसिएशन, नंबर 2 होम मिनिस्टर साहब का वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली उस स्कूल में विजिट करना और उस स्कूल को गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से फंड्स देना, नंबर 3 कि जो एक्यूज है वो किस तरह से सडनली टिटलागढ़ थाने से पावर कट का फायदा उठाकर भाग जाता है। वो पावर कट ऐसे समय में होता है जो कि एक्सपेक्टेड नहीं था। नंबर 4 कि जो उस बच्ची के जो रिमेन्स हैं वो फैमिली को दे दिए गए, अभी फोरेंसिक रिपोर्ट्स जो हैं वो आई नहीं है, उन फोरेंसिक रिपोर्ट्स की एब्सेंस में भी वो रिमेन्स फैमिली को दे दिए गए हैं कि ये आपकी बच्ची के ही रिमेन्स हैं। नंबर 5 कि जिस तरह से एक के बाद ये एक घटनाक्रम हो रहा है उससे ये सब नजर में आता है कि इस मामले की सीबीआई इंक्वायरी जो कि हमारी राज्य सरकार ने अभी तक इसके बारे में कोई निर्णय नहीं लिया है, और जो हमारी राज्य की जो हमारी प्रदेश की जो हमारी इकाई है भारतीय जनता पार्टी की उसने इसके बारे में बार बार अपनी आवाज उठाई है, तो हम सबका भी ये मानना है कि इसके अंदर सीबीआई इंक्वायरी जो है वो जरूरी है और वो होनी ही चाहिए, क्योंकि होम मिनिस्टर साहब ने उनके कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी में ये हादसा होने के बावजूद परिवार से अभी तक मिलने की कोशिश नहीं की, परिवार के लिए सांत्वना के कोई शब्द नहीं कहे, और जिस तरह का उनका हम लोगों की टीम के आने के बाद कल जो बयान आया है उसके बारे में भी आप लोगों को वानती जी ने अपनी बात कही है। सीबीआई इंक्वायरी और किस लिए जरूरी है, क्योंकि अगर कहीं कुछ ना कुछ इसके अंदर कोई षड्यंत्र है तो जो हमारी दूसरी बच्चियां हैं जो हमारी दूसरी टीचर्स वहां पर हैं उन पर किसी तरह की कोई आंच ना आए कहीं किसी तरह के प्रेशर में, इसलिए भी बहुत जरूरी है कि इस मामले की सीबीआई इंक्वायरी होनी चाहिए। और हमें पूरी उम्मीद है माननीय मुख्यमंत्री जी इस बात में पहल करेंगे और वो सीबीआई इंक्वायरी के लिए जांच के आदेश देंगे। ये सभी बातों को लेकर हम अपनी रिपोर्ट माननीय राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष श्री जगत प्रकाश नड्डा जी को प्रस्तुत करने वाले हैं, जो हमारी ऑब्जर्वेशंस हैं जो हमारी रिकमेंडेशंस हैं, और उसके बाद हमारा पार्टी नेतृत्व जो भी निर्णय लेगा उसके बारे में आपको अवगत करवा दिया जाएगा। धन्यवाद।
Did you find any cracks or any evidences or any clues against your allegations regarding Minister of Environment during your visit?
See, whatever that is available in the public domain, we are on that. How separately or parallelly we can conduct an investigation? That is not our job. But we are reflecting the doubts or the suspicion among the minds of the people.
Ma'am, state BJP delegation team under the leadership of state president and IPS officers and advocates has visited the spot and investigated the matter. Do you think they have failed to fact find? That's why the central team is coming to this one.
You need not compare with this. There is a state unit already independently. They have visited the place. They have met their demand. This is the central team. It is on two angles you could see that the central team is very much concerned about the safety and security of women. And our national president, through this delegation, has expressed his condolence to the family at the same time to assist the state unit. So whatever the report they have collected, whatever the demand they have raised, we are going to give it to the national president.
The family members of the victim has given reactions to the media that they are satisfied with the investigation. Then what for future is finding?
You just imagine, sir, in that remote village, from an ordinary poor family, from that living community, whether the parents, they could understand this kind of a complicity of the case? Yes, of course. For their background, if anybody could imagine, they come out openly and saying that, yes, my daughter was having the laptop, my daughter was having the cell phones, and some of the communications were there. How we can expect? Who has pressurized? Minister. We don't know. It is for the investigation to tell them. That's why we are requesting. The minister should not be their boss. How an ordinary officer can interrogate the minister? Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
News 6 Odia, Satya, Sankalpa, Ausankarsa.